Okay, so once again, magandang umaga po sa ating lahat. Ngayon po, ang gusto ko naman pong discuss sa inyo ay ang tungkol sa rectangular coordinates system. Kung paano po mag-plot ng points, kung paano po mag-graph ng linear equation in our rectangular coordinate system. Okay? So bago po tayo magsimula ay gusto ko muna po sa inyong sabihin na paki-subscribe po muna ng ating YouTube channel before we proceed to our lesson. Okay, so once again, so magandang umaga po ulit sa ating lahat. So our lesson for this week is all about rectangular coordinate system. Okay, so kanino nga ba or sino nga ba ang nag-develop ng rectangular coordinate system? So ito po yung nanggaling kay René Descartes. Ano? So ang tunay po talaga niyang pangalan dati ay Cartesian Coordinate System. Okay, so after going through this module, you are expected to illustrate the rectangular coordinate system and it uses and illustrate linear equation. Using plotting points, one associates an ordered pair of real numbers x and y. So with a point in the plane in one-to-one manner. As a result, one obtains two-dimensional Cartesian coordinate system. XY is an ordered pair whose first coordinate is called abscissa and Y is called ordinate. The origin is the intersection of the X and Y axis whose coordinates are 0, 0. So meaning to say that the rectangular coordinate system is the intersection of two number lines. Okay, so the x and y axis divide the coordinate plane in four quadrants. The coordinates of points in quadrant 1 are both positive xy. In quadrant 2, the coordinates of points are negative x and positive y. X coordinate is negative and y coordinate is positive. Okay. Then in quadrant 3, the coordinates are both negative and the coordinates point in quadrant 4 are positive x and negative y. So tandaan lang po natin na dito sa ating rectangular coordinate system, as you can see, so para hindi po kayo malito, so narito po yung ating quadrant 1. Okay, so counterclockwise po siya. Counterclockwise, inuulit ko po, kabaliktaran ng galaw ng kamay ng ating orasan. So here is the quadrant 1, then quadrant 2, quadrant 3, and quadrant 4. Okay? Example. Plot the following points on the coordinate plane. We have A, negative 3, 4. So, negative 3, 4, matatagpuan po natin sa quadrant 2. Okay? So, narito po siya. So, negative 3 siya, di ba? So, negative 3. And then, narito po yung ating negative 3. Okay? So dito po siya, 'di ba? Mauna po muna yung x, 'di ba? XY po yung ating point. So from here, narito yung x and then so from the origin muna po, origin, so going to the left since that is negative. And then since that is positive 4, So, upward by 4 units. So, dito po yung ating A na point, which is negative 3, 4. Then, ang B po natin ay matatagpuan natin sa quadrant 4. Okay? So, positive 2 and negative 3. Okay, positive 2 and negative 3. And then, ang C po natin ay yung 0, 2. So, 0 po siya. And then, positive y-axis. Okay? And then, D, which is 4, 0. So, positive 4 po siya. Dito po siya. Then, 0. Okay? In plotting points, always start from the origin and look for the first number in the x-axis, then move up or down depending on the y-coordinates. When y-coordinate is positive, move upward. And then if it is negative, move downward. So let us have another example of plotting points. So here is, we have the Cartesian coordinates plane. Okay, so give me a point na pwede nating ma-plot. So for example, we have let's say 3, 5. Okay, 3, 5. Okay. So ang 3, 5 po ay matatagpuan natin sa quadrant 1. Ito po ulit ang quadrant 1. Okay. So once again, ito yung ating quadrant 1. We have the quadrant 2. Then quadrant 3. Then quadrant 4. Okay? So yan po. So yung ating 3, 5, siya po ay matatagpuan natin sa, saan po natin matatagpuan? Dito sa ating quadrant 1. So, from the origin here, okay, so move tayo 1, 2, 3. Okay, positive kasi ano. And then, since that is positive 5, so move upward. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, dito po yung ating point na 3, 5. So, that is 3, 5. Okay? So, yan po. And then, so, another example. Sabihin po natin na meron tayong, for example, ay negative 4 and negative 5. Okay. Negative 4 and negative 5. Okay? So, saan po natin matatagpuan ang negative 4 and negative 5? So, doon po natin siya matatagpuan sa quadrant 2. So, from the origin, we have to step to the left by 4 units. So, we have 1, 2, 3, 4. And then, since that is positive, so upward po ulit. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. So, napapansin nyo po, siya ay katabi noong, sila ay magkapantay noong 3, 5. Okay. Magkaiba lang sila ng quadrant. That is negative 4 and positive 5. Okay. So, yan po. Diba na ang dali lang umag-plot ng point sa ating rectangular coordinate system. Okay, another example. So, give me an ordered pair. Okay, so very good. Let's say we have negative 5 and negative 4. Okay. So, negative 5 and negative 4. Okay, so saan naman natin siya makikita? So, siya po ay makikita natin sa third quadrant kasi narito po yung negative x and then negative y. So, from the origin, bilang po tayo ng 5 units. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, dito po siya na. And then, downward naman po kasi negative yung ating y. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. Okay, so yun po. Ito yung point natin ng negative 5 and negative 4. Okay. So, ito po yung ordered pair niya. Okay? And then, let us have another example. Let's say, ang example natin ay, so, for example, we have positive 3 and negative 4. Okay. So, ang positive 3 and negative 4 ay matatagpuan po natin in what quadrant? Very good. Doon po natin siya makikita sa ating quadrant 4. Kasi po siya ay positive x and then negative y. So, from the origin, para ma-plot natin, so count the 3 units. So, 1, 2, 3. And then, downward by 4 units. 1, 2, 3, 4. So, ito po yung ating point na 3 and negative 4. So, yan. So, ganun lang po siya kadali mag-plot ng points. Okay? So, let us continue. So, as you can see, so, we have the learning task 1. So, in learning task 1, so, you are going to plot the points. And then, in letter B, so, identify the quadrant or axis of the following points. At ito po ay gagawin ninyo sa inyo sa ating Google Forms na naka-attach na po sa ating Google Classroom. Okay? So, this time, proceed na po tayo sa linear equation. So, tapos na po tayo kung natapos po natin kung paano tayo mag-plot ng points and then how to locate points in our rectangular coordinate system. So, an equation in the form of ax plus by equals c is called a linear equation in two variables where a, b, and c are constants. Ibig sabihin po, yan po ay numerical. And at least one of a and b are not equal to 0. So, hindi po dapat siya equal to 0. Ano? Kasi kung 0 po siya, hindi na po siya linear equation. This is also referred to as the standard form of linear equation. So, ayan po yung standard form ng linear equation, ax plus by equals c. The symbols x and y are variables that represents any number that will satisfy the equation. So, the equation 2x plus 3y equals 32 is an example of linear equation in two variables. This equation will only be true if we can find an ordered pair. Okay. So, for example, so, which of the following ordered pairs will make the equation 2x plus 3y equals 32, which is true? Okay. Is it A or B? So, for the first ordered pair, if x is equal to 4 and y is equal to 10, then if we are going to substitute it in our linear equation, so we have now 2 times 4, which is 8, 3 times 10 is equal to 30. Then 8 plus 30 is not equal to 32. So, meaning to say, yung ating 410 ay hindi siya satisfy in this linear equation. Kasi po, 38 is not equal to 32. So, therefore, the ordered pair 410 did not make the equation true. Another example, yung 10-4 naman po. For the second ordered pair, x is equal to 10 and y is equal to 4, So substitute the value of x and y. So we have 2 times 10, which is equal to 20. Then 3 times 4 is equal to 12. And 12 added to 20 is 32. So the ordered pair 10-4 satisfies the given equation. Okay? So yun po ang ating tinatawag na solution set. Okay? So here are the table which is the linear equation x plus y equals 3. So here is the value of y. So if we have a given value of y, so easily makukuha po natin ang value ng x, ang makukuha natin easily ang value ng y. So if x is equal to 1, so the value of y is equal to 2. That is because so transposition, so 3 minus 1 is 2. Transposition, 3 minus 2 is equal to 1. So the value of y is 1. Then transposition, so we have 0 as the value of y. And then 3 minus 4 is negative 1. And if we transpose positive 5 to the other side, it will be negative. So 3 minus 5 is negative 2. So therefore, the ordered pairs are 1, 2, 2, 1, 3, 0, 4, negative 1, and 5, negative 2. Okay? So, iyan po yung ating graph ng ating equation. So, if we plot the points, so ito na po yung graph niya. So, as you can see, all the points form a straight line. Kasi nga, linear equation. From the word linear equation, we can form the straight line. Using the graph, you can determine the slope of the line. So, kung tayo po may line, ibig sabihin, meron po tayong makukuha ang slope. Okay? So, the slope of a line is a number that measures its steepness. Okay? Katirikan. Okay? It is also characterized the direction of the line. It is determined by the rise over run between the two points. Rise over run. Pag sinabi nating rise, yun po yung change in y. Then, ang run naman po ay change in x. Okay. So, the graph at the right is the equation x plus y equals negative 1. So, the slope of the line can be determined by the rise over the run between the two points. So, m is used as to represent the slope of a line. Okay, so, ang m po, yun po yung ginagamit nating symbol in getting the slope of the line. M in the French word is to monter. Monter, ibig sabihin, mount, diba? Ganon, mounting. Okay, kaya po siya ay letter m. So, ito po yung ating rise. Ito yung ating dalawang points, negative 3 and 2. And we have 3, negative 4. So, ito po yung rise natin. And then, kapantay nito, yung po yung run. Kung bibilangin po natin, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 po siya, di ba? And then, from here, since that is going to the right, okay? So, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 din po. So, and since that is going to the right nga, kaya po siya ay negative 6. And 6 over negative 6 is negative 1. So, from the point 3, 4, the run is 6. However, since the direction is to the left, you use negative 6. Negative is used for direction. The rise is 6 units. So, the slope is negative when the line falls to the right. Okay, so to the right po kasi, kung siya ay to the left, ibig sabihin, yun naman po yung positive. So, when the line rises to the right, the slope is positive naman po. Okay? Take note of that. Okay. So, the graph of the equation negative 2x plus 3y equals negative 5. So, it is a line that rises to the right. The slope is So from here, negative 2, negative 3, diba yon? And then we have 4, 1. Bakit negative 2, negative 3? Kasi kapag ito po ay ating sinubstitute dito, so it will become positive 4, then negative 3 and negative positive 9. Magiging positive 9 po siya. And positive 9, the added to negative 4, positive 4, so magiging na po siyang negative 5. Kaya siya ay solution set na tinatawag. And then yung 4, 1 naman po, so 4 times negative 2 is negative 8. Then 1 times 3, we have positive 3. And negative 8 added to positive 3 is negative 5. So solution set din po siya. Okay? So once again, rise over run. So from here, so simulan po natin. Rise nga po kasi 1, 2, 3, 4. Then run to the left at to the right. Kasi po siya ay yung positive. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, 4 over 6. Then, the simplest form is 2 thirds divisible by 2. Kaya po yung ating slope of the line is 2 thirds. Okay? So, given only 2 points, so may 2 points na po tayo. Ibig sabihin, kung may 2 points na tayo, we have x sub 1 and y sub 1 and x sub 2, y sub 2. So, without the graph, you can find the slope of the line using the formula. So, the formula is m is equal to y sub 2 minus y sub 1, x sub 2 minus x sub 1. So, for example, find the slope of the line that passes through negative 3, 2, and 3, negative 4. So, the solution, so let's say if x sub 1 is negative 3, y sub 1 is positive 2. So, ito po yun, yung ating point 1. Then, ang point 2 po natin ay 3, negative 4. So, we have x sub 2 is 3 and y sub 2 is negative 4. So, therefore, we have now negative 4 minus 2. So, yun. Diba, y sub 2 minus y sub 1. So, yun nga po, negative 4 minus 2. Then, sa denominator naman po natin, we have 3 minus negative 3. So, yun po. And then, perform the indicated operation. So, we have now negative 4 minus 2 is negative 6. 3 minus negative 3. So, in the loss of integers, operation of integers, so it will let us proceed to addition, then change the sign of the subtrahend. So from negative, magiging po siyang positive. Then proceed to addition, so we have now 3 plus 3. So that is equal to 6. And negative 6 divided by 6 is negative 1. So ibig sabihin, ang ating slope of the line is negative 1. So yun nga po, gaya sabi kanina, kahit hindi po natin siya i-graph in the rectangular coordinate system, if we have a given 2 points, makukuha po natin ang slope of the line. Okay, so here is our learning task 2. Okay, so in learning task 2, what we're going to do is to get the value of y. So, if we have the given x, so isasubstitute lang po natin yung value ng x dito para makuha natin yung y. And then from this, isusulat na po natin yung ordered pair. Okay? Then ang letter B, determine the slope of the line given 2 points. So, gaya ng ating example kanina, so if we have a given 2 points, so pwede na po natin makuha yung slope of a line by using this formula. Ito po yung ating formula. Okay? Ayan. Then, for our learning task 3, so read the instruction carefully. Then, plot and label the following points. So, ito po yung ating following points. Ipa-plot lang po natin dito sa ating rectangular coordinate system. Diba? Napakadali lang yan, mga kapatid. Okay? And then, for our letter B, so this time, kayo na ngayon ang magbibigay ng value ng x. And then, if you have the value of x, then you can get the value of y. So, find 3 solution for 3 linear equations for x minus 3y equals 1. So, and plot the solutions as points on the coordinate plane. So, at your own, give the value of x to get the value of y. Okay, then in learning task 4, read the instruction carefully. So, given x plus 2y, find the two solutions of the given equation. Kayo din po ang magbibigay ng value ng x. And then, from that value of x, you can get the value of y. Then, graph the two points. Then, find the slope. So, and then, for letter B, draw the map of your community where your house is at the origin, then plot of these 5 houses of your classmates. Write the coordinate of each classmate's house. So from the ordinate, the origin 0, 0, dito po yung ilalagay nyo yung inyong bahay. Okay, so another, let us have another example of how to get the slope of the line given 2 points. Okay, and then how to plot the or graph a line. Okay, so for example, let's say we have from here, so ito po makukuha natin yung ating so let us draw a line. So pag pala assuming that it is a straight line. Okay, so from here, kung mapansin nyo, plot siya, ano, plot po siya, negative 4, 5, 3 and 5. Okay, so from here class, since let's say we have yung ating pong formula kanina. Okay, ito yun naman po ating gamitin. So, formula natin kanina, let's say we have m is equal to, diba, y sub 2 minus y sub 1. So, we have 5 minus 5. Diba? Over 3, kung ito yung ginamit natin una, so ito yung po yung ating y sub 2. So, 3 minus negative 4. Huwag po kayong malilito doon, kasi kung yun po yung ginamit nyo sa y, dapat ganun din ang gagamitin nyo sa x. Okay? So, therefore, we have now 5 minus 5 is 0 over 3 minus negative 4. So, once again, proceed to addition, then change the sign of negative 4. So, it will become positive 4. Added to 3, so we have now 7. And 0 divided by 7 is equal to 0. Ayan po, 0. Kaya po, ang ating slope of the line here is 0. Pantay po siya, diba? So, wala siyang steepness. Okay? Another one. Let us connect this two points. Okay, assuming that it is a straight line once again. Okay. One. So, we have 3, 5 and 3, negative 4. Okay. So, once again, let us solve for the value of m or the slope of the line. So, m is equal to, we have negative 4 minus 5. So, negative 4 minus 5 over 3 minus 3. So 3 minus 3. So therefore, we have now ang ating numerator ay negative 9, di ba? So negative 9 over 3 minus 3 is 0. And what is the value of negative 9 divided by 0? So once again, that is undefined po. Undefined. Hindi pa po na-define kung ano ang value ng number divided by 0. Kaya kung mapapansin ninyo, siya ay vertical line. Kapag po vertical line, undefined po yung ating slope. So, the slope of the line is undefined. Compared to this, 0 po, horizontal line. Okay? This time naman po, ang ating pong i-connect ay ito. Okay? Sana mag-connect straight line. Wow! Yan. And then, enjoy lang po natin ang pag-drawing ng straight line. Okay. So, this time, our value of y, so m is equal to ang y sub 2 natin ay negative 4. So, negative 4 then minus 5. Okay? Negative 4 minus 5. And then, over negative 5. Negative 5 minus 3. Okay. So, we have now 4 minus 5 is negative 9. Diba? Negative 9. And then, negative 5 minus 3 is negative 8. Okay. So, as you can see, the numerator and the denominator are both negative. And negative divided by negative, so cancel po natin siya. So, it will become positive. So, 9 over 8. So, kaya nga po, nakikita nyo yung line natin ay going to the right. Ano? So, siya ay papaangat papuntang kanan. Kaya po, ang ating slope ay positive. Ngayon po, yung ating pagre-represent ng y sub 1 at y sub 2, pwede po siyang magkabaliktad. Okay? Actually, pwede po siyang magkabaliktad. So, for example po, let's say, di ba sabi, ang ginamit natin na ano dito ay yung negative 4 minus 5. Ito naman pong gamitin natin, 5 minus 4. So, let's say m is equal to, so, 5 minus negative 4. Okay? Over 5 minus negative 4. So, over, we have 3 minus negative 5. So, 3 minus negative 5. Okay. So, m is equal to, we have 5 minus negative 4. So, properties of integers. So, proceed to addition. Then, change the sign of the subtrahend. So, we have 9. Diba? So, positive 9. Over 3 minus negative 5, and that is equal to also to 8. So, as you can see, magkapareho po sila, 9 over 8. So, meaning to say, kahit po magkabaliktad ang representation nyo ng x and x sub 2, y sub 1, x sub 1, okay lang po yun. Okay? So, this time, ito naman po yung ating i-connect. So, not to web. Oh, yes. Okay. So, yan po. Okay? So, ang given po natin ay gamit tayo ng blue. Okay. So, ang given po natin, we have M is equal to 5 minus 4. So, 5 minus negative 4. Okay? So, yan. Yan po yung minus, ha? Over negative 4 minus 3. So, negative 4 minus 3. Okay. Then, let's say we have the value of m is equal to. So, 5 minus 4 and that is positive 9. Diba? Over negative 4 minus 3 and that is negative 7. Positive divided by negative is negative. Kaya naman po, ang ating slope of the line is negative. Kasi yung nung ating pong i-generap siya, so we have ang ating pong linya ay going downward to the right. Okay? Rises to the left. Ika nga. Okay? Kaya po, ang ating slope of the line is negative. Okay? Ngayon naman po, kung tayo ay mayroong given na, let's say, 3x minus 4y equals 8. Okay. Paano po kung tayo po magre-represent ng x? So, let's say, x is equal to 3. So, what is the value of y? Ano po kaya ang magiging value ng y? Okay, so substitute. So, 3 times the value of x is 3. So, we have 3 times 3 minus 4y equals 8. Diba? And then 3 times 3 is 9. And then minus 4y equals 8. Then ililipat po natin sa kabila, transposition, so negative 4y equals, so 8 minus 9, di ba? So we have now negative 4y is equal to 8 minus 9 is negative 1, di ba? Then divide both sides by negative 4. Solving equation lang po tayo, na ha? Okay? So, cancel na po yung negative 4. So, therefore, y is equal to negative 1 divided by negative. So, pwede na po nating makancel yung negative. So, 1/4 na lang po. Okay? So, therefore, ang ating pong ordered pair ay 3 and 1/4. So, yun po. Kapag ipinalat natin siya sa ating rectangular coordinate plane. At saan po matatagpo ng 3 and 1/4? Dito po sa first quadrant. Kasi po siya ay both positive. Okay? So, hanggang dyan na lang po ang ating video tutorial. So, sana po ay na-gets natin, mas mapadali natin kung paano natin ma-plot ng points sa rectangular coordinate system the same time kung paano ang pagkuha ng ordered pair. Okay? So, hanggang sa muli, marami pong salamat. At sana po ay makatulong itong ating video tutorial para sa ating kabataan.